just coming into the Azure portal. Already we have done our conditional split by using filter statement. Okay, the same thing with the if else, we will do that. Just launching ADF Studio. The same time we prepare some other data sets in the target container. For the target, I am going to use the storage lake 104. Here already I have some containers. So container X, container Y, these two things, two separate targets by using filter statement we have done. Two separate filters, again for each filter, we applied for each, under for each copy activity, okay? So this is just a trial of practice for that already some existed containers within that. Again, some files are there. So for you, freshly, I will create new containers. Let's set target one as container number one. And one more container, target two. This is second container. Okay. Some files we need to distribute into target one, some remaining. That means the condition matching files into target one, false files into target. So this exercise we are going to do now. As usual, first step, you need to create data sets for that. Already have linked service for storage lake 104. No need to create. So come to ADF Studio. Here you have pencil icon and go to the category data sets. Today the portal is a little slow, sir. Okay, meanwhile it is loading, graphically I will explain what exactly the pipeline flow here. Let me take paint. So our exercise is this one, conditional split. Using if else activity, if condition activity. The first step, get metadata activity. Within this, what are the required configurations? We'll ask you data set. The data set I am selecting as storage lake 101. Okay. Underscore source. Already have seen. We have multiple files within this container. Of course, our tag is like this. DS underscore. And also one more thing, child items. You should configure, okay, under area of items. This is the first step. For this, add one more tag, one more activity. This activity I am using here for each activity. For each activity, you have to select the items. That means what should be the input of it. What is the input of it? At the rate. Activity of get metadata. So whatever the name you have given here. Suppose if you give ABC, just activity of ABC. Okay. Get metadata. Dot output. Dot child items. Six small. Okay, this is input for this. The input should be configured over here. If I have 10 files within this, 10 times the loop will be running. So within this for each activity, definitely one sub activity should be configured. Sub activity. In the place of sub activity, I am giving if else. If condition activity. Understood? If it is if condition activity, it will ask you the expression. What is that expression it is taking? It is a part of child items. Understood? It is a part of child items. How many items are there? That many times the loop will be running. At each iteration, it is taking item. At that item, you have to take name. But you have to apply a condition. At the rate. Starts with. But now item becomes sub function. That's why at the rate symbol not applied. Comma, yeah. That is whatever condition. Whenever it asks you the expression, give the filter condition. There are so many string functions. What function you want to apply, just search the function list and your required function you just apply. Already how to apply multiple conditions also, I have explained by using logical functions. There are many logical functions like or, and, not, equals, okay, greater or equals, like that. So there are no specific operators, everything is a function here in the ADF. Okay, so whenever you have given one function, there are two possibilities for you. One is true part, second one is false part. So for this condition, I'm giving you two things. This is a true activity. Here you have to configure false activity. In the place of true activity, give copy. Here one copy activity. Here also, copy activity. But here sync is data set of target path. Source is same. Here sync should be target. Suppose my first file name is EMP. What happens with the condition? Condition false. The EMP file will be copied into target. Second file is apple.txt. Condition true. The file will be copied into target. So in a high level, how many activities are there here? In the pipeline, in a high level, how many activities? Only two. Only that get metadata and for each one. Under for each is sub activity. Under if again, copy is again sub as part of true activity and false activity. Got it. Now if you run this pipeline, automatically the data distribution will happen instead of going for two separate filters. Okay. Again, for each filter, you have applied separate for each also. The previous exercises. Understood. Let me check this. I'm going to create a new data set for the fresh containers. Under data lake, target one. Already we have linked service, no need to create. I'm selecting the file path, that is container path. Today, unfortunately, the portal is slow, sir. Target path. But no need to select the directory or files, because we are going to push multiple files into this. Save OK. So it's created. One more thing I am going to create. New data set. Data like Gen 2. This time data set name DS underscore storage lake 104 underscore target 2. Only container name I am giving. Liquid service 104. Selecting that target 2. So finally okay. I'm not going to care about whether it is header or not. Simply, I want to push multiple files. Okay. Whenever you want to work with a particular file, that is important for you. So that too, before selecting that, first of all, you have to check the sample data, preview data. If really file is having header, then only select that option. Suppose if file is not having header, then first row will be skipped if you select that option. Okay. Okay. Data sets are created. Target, everything, full name, it is not highlighted. Okay, just publish. I think for the first data set, we have given a storage like 101 name by mistake. 101, 104. Okay, that is just a name, just remember. Okay, now we can design our pipelines. I'm going for a new pipeline. Subname copy split, subname I have given. Please check the flow. Your first activity is get metadata. First, let's finish the configuration of it. Under data sets, our input is a source container. Okay. And field list you need to configure. Just under field list you have child items. Okay. Now for this, in the next step, I am going to add for each item. But for each input should be from output of get metadata, right? For each. Just connecting these two. Now I'm going to configure for each activity. Within that settings, under settings, I am choosing sequential option. Items means what should be the input for this. Okay. Go for add dynamic content. Output of get metadata. Under output, you have a lot of fields, but you don't want all the fields. You need only child items. Okay. Now, child items is the array within that array items are there. In the next step, we are going to work with those items. But if it is for each compulsory, at least one activity should be there. So go into the sub activities. In the place of activity, I want to give if condition activity. Just click on this pencil for the activity creation. Search for if, this is whatever if condition. Okay. Within that if, one is true part, second one is false part. Just click on this for configuring. You have to give condition. Sorry, not here. In the place of activities list, there are two things. True, false, but true or false based on what? Given condition. The given condition is like this. The input is coming from current item of each, for each, that is item. Under that, your required thing is name. You want to check with the condition? Starts with. Item of name, comma, all files which are starting with A, that should be into one directory, remaining into other directory. One simple condition. So the condition you have given here. Finally, our expression is ready. But still two things are pending. True activity and false activity. So now check this. Till now this is ready. These two things you are going to configure. Okay. Please check the title. I am in true activities. You can give single activity and also you can give multiple activities also. Of course, to achieve our task, single activity is enough. So here I am giving copy activity. Okay. The source is single. Go for source. What is your input data set? Storage lake DS101. Sorry. Storage lake 101 underscore source, which has multiple files. But you don't want to work with all the files. because you are under a for each loop. At one iteration, it has to take one file. That's why I came into wildcard file path. Here you have to select. I'm taking at the rate item. Under that name. Got it? So this thing you have select. Item and name. But item and name is directly accepted or not, you want to check. Yeah. Dot output. I think already we have, okay, let's try with this one. Child items dot item dot name. Okay, because here you have only one option, that is get metadata one output. Okay, that name you are going to post it over here. I'm saying okay now. If it gives error, directly we try with item off, because already we are in for each. Not only the files, every line it will be taking, all the fields it will be taking. Understand? Yes. Item dot. So here actually bracket is not required for the child item. Child items itself is an array, not a function. It's not a function, it's an array field. Okay. Dot item of dot name. So directly we can, I think we can go with item of name. So first let me check. Let's check with this. Okay. And sync. What is that sync? Recently we have created target one something. Let me. Yeah, this one, target one. Sync is ready now. It's all a part of true activity. Same thing for false activity we need to get. I'm going for false activity now. Same copy activity. In the place of source, selecting same previous data set, which is source. Choosing the path. Dot child items. Dot item of. Dot name. Only we are trying to keep only the file name after the container name. Okay. Source is ready. Now sync. Which is target 2. Already we have created a data set for target 2. Target. Okay, all configurations ready. It's for each. It's entire your pipe. In a high level, there are only two activities. Just weld it. Running under debug mode. failed to run the pipeline. Maybe some error. Let me go with only at the right item. It's for true activity. Same thing doing for false activity. Okay. Just a minute. Under for each, under your settings, the input is output child items. Already here we have done. Yeah. Okay. Now trying the same thing. Process is going on, but not a trigger, just a triggering now. Please check the steps, sir. The only first activity completed, remaining all activities are in progress. But try to understand the flow from the bottom to top, sir. The execution steps, all of you. Prashant, you asked me a question, sub activities will run first. It's not like that. Just I will explain what is the meaning of your sub activity, your question. Just a minute. Generally, the free trials will be very busy on weekends, sir. Free trials. Because paid subs, paid accounts like always will be available. Because the resources engaged for free trial is different. The resource engaged for pay-as-you-go model is different. Because especially if it is weekend, all your IT professionals will be working only on weekends only. So that's why in weekends it will be busy, very busy. Okay. Sir, all of you observe the steps. Mr. Prashant, for our question, answer is in this explanation only. Please check from the bottom, sir, and compare with this our picture. Okay, first keep it in mind about this picture. What is the first activity triggered? Get metadata. After completion of get metadata, only you entered into the second activity, which is for each activity. Okay, but within that for each activity, what is there? One more sub activity is there. Sub activity starts execution. Suppose it is going to iterate for 10 times. After completion of 10 iterations of sub activity, only the for each activity will be completed. Still, till then, the status will be in progress. First, the job will be first activity will be in the queue. Next, running mode. That means progress mode. If any activity failure or success happened, then it will be, then status is finished. Understood. Prashant, are you okay? Suppose without completion of for each, if you started, even though if one is started, before completion of that if, copy is started. After completion of this copy execution, if is completed. Such a kind of ifs 10 completed, then for each will be completed because I have 10 items. Understood. Now all files which are starting with EA will be into what is that? The target one, which are not starting with EA, targeted. Understood. So based on this, I want to give one assignment. All of you, please try to do this. Suppose your client is daily sending files. That too, these files are about sales. We have a data lake. Under data lake, the container is sales. Under sales, the data is like this. Okay. So the format here, the naming standard here for the file is the first four are about year. Next two digits about month. Next two digits about a day. In this way, a lot of files we have. And one more file is there. Today date 18. There is no guarantee all files will be only sales transactions. Sales related may be other files also. In this way, I have data. Container has files. Since 2001 to till date. Daily you may get a single file or daily you may get multiple files or in some day you may not get a file also. Okay. Now the task is like this. All files of 2018, 19, 20, 21. All, not all files, all sales files only. Suppose there is a file called personal, I don't want it. There might be a file called product, I don't want it. Only transactions. Because I want to provide these 4 years data to my business intelligence team. Okay. So all sales files of 2018, 19, 20, 21 into sales BI container of same data lake or different data lake account. Okay. Remaining into just core BI container. So here you have to concentrate on two things. One is the file name before extension that should end with sales. The clue for you is whether it is a sales file or not sales file. Before extension, last characters are sales. Okay. For the year, already have clue. The first four digits are about year. How to fetch first four? Try for function. Generally in SQL, what is the function you have? Substring. Okay. The substring function is available. How to fetch four characters first of a file name and how to fetch last five characters of that file name. Okay. Two functions ready. After that, how to apply two different conditions by using end operator. Again, within that end, year can be 18, 19, 20, 21. It can be of anything. Understand? This is somewhat a little complex. Of course, it's not complex. Length is more. Okay. That means multiple conditions you need to apply. That too, I don't want this with using filter. I want it using by using if condition activity. That means get metadata for each if condition. Within that if condition, what condition you have to go, just plan it. Understood. Okay. All of you, please execute this. Take a screenshots and send me email. Already have my email ID. Once again, I am typing. At Gmail. Okay, sir, all of you. Let's see in tomorrow class. If you are new to me, take email ID. Sir, any photos, na? Appropriate task one, sir. Appropriate task one, sir. Please write. Don't use the technology too much, man. Okay, sir. Thank you very much. Let's see tomorrow.